If after a meem sakin, there appears another meem, idgham with ghunna will take place. In other words, the two memes will merge together and the sound is made entirely by the nose through the nasal passage, holding it for two counts, keeping your lips closed. For example, in this verse, we see a meem sakin and after it, another meem. So if I am going to read these two words, it will read as lakum min. I closed my lips, the M sound came through the nasal passage, and I held it for two counts. If after a meem sakin, there appears the letter ba, ikhfa will take place. This means it is pronounced with a light nasal sound in the nose for two counts, keeping the lips slightly open. The sound of the meem is hidden and the lips are shaped, ready to pronounce the ba. In this verse, we see a meem sakin, i.e. with no vowel on it, followed by the letter ba. So if I am going to read these two words, it will read as fahkum bainahum. I brought a light nasal sound through my nose, ready to pronounce the letter ba, and held it for two counts. If after a meem sakin, there appears any other letter besides meem or ba, the meem must be pronounced clearly. For example, here it says am lahum. My lips came together as should when saying the meem clearly.
Sadaqallahul 'Azim.